boy toy? I have one too. None of this is my fault. He made me control Superman.
What's his name?
He calls himself Hush.
The events of the past months reach as high as Superman and as low as the Joker. All were set into motion by Hush.
Hi, this is Marc Morrell from ToonBarn. We're here at the 50th anniversary of San Diego Comic-Con. We're talking about Batman Hush. The world premieres here.
Yeah, tonight.
And I'm here with Geoffrey Arend, who plays the Riddler.
Yeah. It's a thrill to be here, especially, I mean, it's the 80 years of Batman, too. So it's like an incredible story to be a part of, too. I mean, I if you're familiar with the graphic novel, if you're familiar with, like, the comics, this takes Batman to places we've never really seen before. Emotionally, physically, romantically. It's really cool. And your shirt shows, you know?
So, riddle me this. What is Batman's greatest defeat?
Batman's greatest defeat. I guess if I was playing Batman, if I was like Bruce Wayne, it would be getting emotionally involved in anything. So I think like that image right there says it all. He's allowing himself to like put down one of his walls, one of his shields, protecting himself, and he lets Catwoman in. And when that happens, once you pull down one side of yourself, the other side start to fall too. So this is a cool story. It takes him to places we've never seen before.
At one point in the graphic novel, he's supposed to be thinking about, you know, solving the crime, and all he can think about is, I kissed her.
Yeah. Yeah, and who would blame him? You know what I mean? It's like, I mean, we've all been waiting for it. You know, he's definitely been waiting for it. It's like, I mean, the idea of falling in love with somebody who's so right for you and so wrong at the same time, we've all been there, we've all had that, you know, and it's like that, for Batman, who's carrying so much weight on his shoulders, you know, it's so interesting to see it play out.
Normally, Riddler is more of a loner type of villain, but he's a little bit more connected in this than we realize, isn't he?
Yeah, just like in the graphic novel, I mean, he plays an integral part of connecting this entire rogues gallery together, and I think it's in line with what he's been trying to do. He thinks he's smarter than everybody else. He's jealous of Batman. He knows that Batman is just as smart as he is, you know, and he would never admit that, but he knows it deep in his core. So it's like, how do you get him off balance, you know? And it's such an interesting thing that happens to him and the way he employs it. So I can't wait for fans to see it.
It's going to be world premiere is tonight.
Yeah. 4,000 people. It's going to be incredible.
So thank you for joining us on ToonBarn.
My pleasure. And tomorrow it's available on DC Online and all digital. And then August 6th on Blu-ray.
Yes.
Yeah.
That's a show with Kim Daly as well, you might remember. Any Madam Secretary fans out there? How about 500 Days of Summer? How about Geoffrey Arend as the Riddler?
Geoffrey, I know you're quite the comics and animation fan. Where did you approach the Riddler from?
It's hard not to have John Glover's head and voice in my head. I was such a fan of the animated series, so that was there, and I just didn't want to screw it up. And to get the benefit of being a Lazarus Pit Riddler was great. It was a great entry into putting my own stamp on it, because it's just like, it's methed out, you know, wanting recognition, and just at his worst and most extreme. So it was just a lot of fun to do. This is my first time seeing it with everybody here, so I'm still kind of shaking and in shock. It's such a good movie.
It is.
Hey, I'm not resisting.
Where is he?
I know not whom you speak of.
Hush put you up to this.
Can you rephrase that in the form of a riddle?
There was no riddle. That's the point.
Maybe I'm trying something new. You know, shake things up. Shake, shake, shake.
flesh.